We are on the passive sniffing. So passive sniffing, the traffic is locked but it is not altered in any way. And passive sniffing allows listening only, and it works with hub devices. And on a hub device, the traffic is sent to all the ports, and therefore an attacker uses the hub to connect systems. All hosts on the network can see the traffic, and attacker can easily capture traffic going through. And the good news is that hubs are almost absolute nowadays. So most modern networks uses switches, but hence passive sniffing is no more effective right now. Okay, the second one is active sniffing. So in active sniffing, the traffic is not only locked and monitored, but it is also be altered in some way as determined by the attack. As the attack wants to control that traffic, it can control that according to requirement, attacker's requirement. And active sniffing is used to sniff a switch based network. Okay, so earlier passive sniffing have some problem with switches, but now in active sniffing there is no problem related to switched based network. So it involves injecting address resolution packets, ARP, okay, address resolution packets, to get the address about the packets into a target network to flood on the switch. So contain addressable memory, CAM table. Okay, so CAMs keep track of which host is connected to which port. So all details will be sniffed by the attacker. And following are the active sniffing techniques. So here you can see MAC flooding, DHCP attacks, DNS poisoning, and spoofing attacks, and ARP poisoning. Okay, so these are the techniques used for sniffing, active sniffing techniques. And protocol which are affected are like you can see here some protocols. So protocols such as the TRIAD and TRUE TCP/IP were never designed with security in mind, mostly in IP version 4. Okay, so therefore do not offer much resistance to potential intruders. And there are several protocols that are easily sniffed. So first is HTTP. It is used to send information in the clear text without any encryption, and thus a real target. Okay, and SMTP, simple mail transfer protocol. So SMTP is basically utilized in the transfer of email. So this protocol is efficient, but it does not include any protections or security against sniffing. And then next one is NNTP. Okay, so network news transfer protocol. It is used for all types of communication, but its main topic is that data and even passwords are sent over the network as clear text, so anyone, or you can say mostly attackers, can see the password. Okay, the next is POP, post office protocol. And POP is strictly used to receive emails from the servers. Okay, so this protocol does not include protections against sniffing because it can be trapped, and mostly IP version in IP version 4. Okay, and then FTP, file transfer protocol. So FTP is used to send and receive files, but it does not offer any security features. All the data is sent as clear text, like POP, and that can be easily sniffed. And IMAP, Internet Message Access Protocol, it is the same like SMTP. Its function is same like SMTP and highly vulnerable to sniffing. Okay, and the last one is Telnet. Telnet sends everything, users, names, passwords, keystrokes, over the network as clear text, and hence it can be easily sniffed and mostly targeted by the attacker. Okay, and some utilities, or you can say tools, are used for analyzing these details for sniffers. Okay, and if someone want to analyze each packet, save the capture and review it whenever time allows. Okay, so there are some analyzers like hardware protocol analyzers. So it is important that hardware analyzers like the devices plug into the network at the hardware level and can monitor traffic without manipulating it. So mostly the devices are plugged into the network directly, hardware devices, and can monitor traffic without manipulating it. So hardware protocol analyzers are used to monitor and identify the malicious network traffic generated by hacking software installed in the system, like firewall, software firewall and hardware firewall. Okay, they capture a data packet, decode it and analyze its content according to certain rules. And also hardware protocol analyzers allows attackers to see individual data bytes of each packet passing through the cable. So these hardware devices are not readily available to most ethical hackers due to their enormous cost in many cases, okay. And lawful interceptions. So lawful interceptions is defined as legally sanctioned access to communication network data, such as telephone calls or email messages, okay. And also LI or lawful interceptions must always be in pure sense of a lawful authority for the purpose of analysis or evidence. And LI is a security process in which a network operator or service providers gives law enforcement official permission to access private communication of individuals or organizations. Sometimes government will use this snipping system or tools, or sometimes some individual organizations to check the details of the communication of individuals or organizations related employees. So there are some LIs, okay, or you can say legally sanctioned access to communication network data for getting information about the individuals or organization. And almost all countries have drafted and enacted legislations or laws to regulate lawful interceptions procedures, okay. And standardization groups are creating LI technology specifications, and usually LI activities are taken for the purpose of infrastructure protections and cyber security. Or operator of private network infrastructure can maintain LI capabilities within their own networks as an inherent right unless otherwise prohibited by the law. And LI was formerly known as wiretapping and has existed since the inception of electronic communication. Okay. Then there are some tools related to snipping. Okay, so here you can see. So there are so many tools available to perform snipping over a network, and they all have their own features to help a hacker analyze traffic and dissect the information. And sniffing tools are extremely common applications. Okay, and so here are some tools like BetterCap. Okay, BetterCap is a powerful, flexible and portable tools created to perform various types of MITM attacks. Okay, so I will not provide the details about MITM here. Okay, so you can check on the Google about this MITM attacks against a network, manipulate HTTP and HTTPS and TCP traffic in real time, and sniff to credentials and much more. Okay, then next one is AtterCap. AtterCap is a comprehensive suite for man in the middle attacks. It features sniffing of live connections, content filtering on the fly, and many other interesting tricks. And it supports active and passive dissections of many protocols and includes many features for network and host analysis. Then Wireshark. Already you know about Wireshark. It is one of the most widely known and used packet snippers. It offers a tremendous number of features designed to assist in the dissection analysis of traffic. Already you know about TCP dump. Okay, we have done some you can say practical type work. Okay, we have used some command TCP dump commands to analyze the packets. So well-known command line packet analyzer. Okay, then win dump. Okay, so it is related to Windows. Windows port of the particular port of the popular Linux packet sniffer TCP dump, and which is a command line tools that is perfect for displaying header information like TCP dump. And OmniPick, manufactured by Wild Packets. OmniPick is a commercial product that is the evolution of the product EtherPick. Okay, so I will not provide the detail about EtherPick again here. You can go and search about EtherPick. And then DSniff, a suite of tools designed to perform sniffing with different protocols with the intent of intercepting and revealing password. DSniff is designed for the Unix and Linux platforms and does not have a full equivalent to the Windows platform. Okay, then next is the Ether app. It is a Linux Unix tools designed to display graphically a system's incoming and outgoing connections. And the next one is MSN Sniffer. It is a sniffing utility specifically designed for sniffing traffic generated by the MSN Messenger application. And the last one is here, NetWitness NextGen. It includes a hardware-based sniffer along with other features designed to monitor and analyze all traffic on a network. And this tool is used by the FBI and other law enforcement agency, or mostly security agencies. Okay, so a potential hacker can use any of these sniffing tools or other more tools to analyze traffic on a network and dissect information for special purpose or for data theft or for transferring your or collecting your data to sell to other organizations. So sniffing is a threat, okay? It is a threat, but can be used for good reasons by the government. So that's all about sniffing and sniffing tools. Okay, thank you.